This episode of Orange is the New Black is brought to you by Tweaked Audio. To get awesome headphones, go to tweakedaudio.com and use the coupon code SOUTHGATE to get 30% off, free shipping, and a lifetime warranty. Or you can get there through the link on our website, southgatemediagroup.com.
Another year's gone by. I'm so glad you're with me. The way you lift me up with the love you give me. It's good to know that you'll be mine when days are blue. Oh, what a dream come true.
Welcome back to the Orange is the New Black podcast. I'm Rob Southgate.
I'm Martha Southgate.
And we are talking season 6, episode 8, Gordons.
That makes me want fish. Oh, that's Gordons. Never mind.
Well, it makes as much sense as the shoes that she had. So.
That's true.
Go ahead,
or
Marth.
Storkies.
Storkies. Too funny. Marth, go.
Right. Tasty gets fan mail and an assist from an old friend. Piper lobbies loose check to bring back kickball. Alita tries out a new sales tactic. Okay, that's
okay.
Like one iota of this.
Yeah,
episode.
So if you think that you got the story from that, you are sadly mistaken.
All right, so it starts out our lockdown is over, right?
Yes.
So then they start tossing the cells, and Alex has a phone. Madison had given her the phone, and now she's got to try to deal with hiding it and not getting caught during the searches.
Right, Madison. Does return during this part too, after getting shivved.
Yeah, she's all better.
And she comes in acting all like, oh, look, I got shivved and look how cool I am.
Yeah.
And, yeah.
So,
Alex is like, I'm having nothing to do with this.
Right. But she is because she still has the phone. So she hides it between two pairs of socks on the bottom of her foot.
I was wondering when she explained it, I was like, okay, that makes sense. But she pops her shoe off and I'm going, did she use the what did the other one call it? The prison purse?
Oh gosh, I don't think a phone would fit up there.
The prison
purse. I would hope a phone wouldn't fit up there.
I don't know. What went up?
Oh, the hot sauce went up there, and then the lid came
and
off.
Then the lid came off. Ouch! That reminds me of a story.
No, it doesn't. God, there's no story.
There's no story.
Trust me, people. I expose a lot on this podcast.
I'm not explaining
that one. All right. It didn't.
Now you can't stop.
Because you're implying that it was in the purse.
It was not.
It had
in the
nothing
purse.
To do with the purse.
It had nothing to do with the purse. It actually wasn't even hot sauce, but.
It was jalapeno.
It was jalapeno.
Okay. All right, we're done. okay.
But there was nothing inserted into any purse. I'm just going to say that.
No.
There was nothing, no shenanigans.
No. Okay. So let's talk about Tasty.
Now, are we going to talk about the...
Oh, I guess suppose we should finish Alex, though. So Alex had the phone, yada, yada.
Is there anything more?
Didn't she give it back to Madison?
No.
How'd she get rid of it?
I don't know. I don't recall. She was trying to hide it when they were tossing the cells, and she hid it in her shoe, and then she told Madison she wanted nothing to do with it, and she had it in her... Did she have it in her cast when she gave it to her? Or did she tell her it was in her shoe? I don't remember. It's kind of irrelevant, because really, that was only a plot device. Because now... Piper's telling her you can't be part of their gang.
Oh my
and
God.
Alex is going, I'm not part of a gang. And Madison's like, hey, you're part of a gang. Yeah.
I have to tell you, this episode put me firmly on Team Piper.
Yeah, what happened?
Freaking killed me in this episode. I laughed. I loved every time she was on.
Yeah, they wrote her great in this one.
I don't know what happened because I didn't think it was possible for me to ever be Team Piper.
Is this the episode when she said, I'm terrible at this or I'm bad in prison, or was that the last episode?
I think that was the
Because we liked when she said that.
Oh my
too.
God, it must be this episode. She was hilarious. And she was a great, it was a great time with Piper in this episode. Fight me, anyone who disagrees.
Well, I'm going to pause the conversation for a second because we had on Facebook, Deborah Battle wrote regarding Alex, because on the last episode we talked about how Alex looked like a ghost. Mm-hmm. And I wanted to bring this up because we're talking about her. Mm-hmm. And she still looked like a ghost here. But Deborah said, the reason that Alex looks the way she does, back in camp, they had the right to some makeup. They don't have that in Max. They also have very bright lights, so it's washing her out. She still looks like a ghost.
Well, and they're never out. They're only outside a few minutes a day.
Right.
Because Piper said to Loosecheck that they're legally supposed to have 30 minutes a day, and they're not getting that.
Yeah. They're not.
Right.
So okay. So there you go.
She needs a little bronzer.
Okay. Okay, so back to it. Where? I'm sorry, I derailed us a little bit there, but I wanted to bring that
up. Okay, but which part are we going back to?
Well, I think you wanted to talk about Tasty. Do we want to talk about the entire Tasty story? Because really, this was a Tasty episode.
Let's talk about the Tasty in her entirety.
Okay, so in the current time.
Do you want to start current or do you want to go back in time?
I want to do current.
Okay.
In the current time, we're seeing more of her relationship with Ward.
Yes.
And, I mean, they've already mentioned that they work together. They've mentioned that they have this past together.
So why wouldn't you want to start there?
Well, because I've got a reason.
Do you?
So it shows Ward come to her, and Ward is being her friend.
Yeah.
She's like, you're getting this fan mail, and she's like, oh, and this was in there, and she's super excited. It's an invitation to get interviewed, and she's like, oh, you know, this was supposed to not make it to you, but boom. And Tasty's like, this is awesome. I don't know what I'm going to do. Mm-hmm. And she encourages her. Ward,
I don't think Tasty thought it was awesome. Tasty didn't. I don't think Tasty wanted to do it.
You don't think so?
No, I don't. I seem to recall her not wanting to do it.
And, well, then
she said, no, you can tell your story and do your thing. And
see, I took it as she thought, you know, this is great and everything, but I'm not doing it. I'm in prison. I can't do it.
Okay.
That was the impression.
But you said like something.
Yeah. Okay. So I said it was awesome.
Okay. Yeah. I don't think I ever got that impression from her.
Yes.
But yeah. So Ward encouraged her and said, no, it's okay. You can absolutely do an interview.
Right. And she ended up getting a better lawyer who knew what she was talking about. And Tasty's like, finally a good lawyer. So that must've been something I'm assuming set up by the ACLU.
Yes. Oh, absolutely.
Protecting her, helping her, trying to help her out. Mm-hmm. She gets in there. She does the interview. And I thought the interview was great.
Mm-hmm. Except she's going to die.
Yeah.
Because she outed it all.
She did.
With them standing there.
That was weird.
Why did she do it with guards standing there?
And especially the one guard who's the worst. Mm-hmm. He was standing there. But yeah, she was getting her story out. I thought she was very eloquent. It reminded me of last season when she would get on camera, they write her in such a way that it's like, yeah, she can do that. Mm-hmm. She can speak. But then she did the Tasty and ran her mouth and started talking about getting beaten and all that.
And right. It was and like, Hellman, oh my God.
Now, is it wrong that she did that? No, actually, it's good that she's exposing it, but you've got, Ward helped you.
Right.
Now you're shining a light so that Ward looks guilty. This other guy looks guilty. They're already, you know, some of them are already mad at you.
Yeah.
This was not a good political move.
She has put herself in danger.
Yeah.
And they can make anything look like an accident.
Yeah.
Or that it was another
inmate. Well,
they've got
enough of a light on her at this point that I think that would be trickier. But she can certainly get beaten or privileges taken away.
Like, yes.
They can mess with her in big, painful ways.
Well, no matter what, Ward is now no longer on her side.
Right.
And she really had an ally there. I don't know why she didn't realize that she was about to.
Now, here's that. This is why I wanted to do the flashback second.
Okay.
Because what you just said,
mm-hmm.
In the flashback, we see that Tasty and Ward work together at Storky's.
Yes.
And which that whole thing,
they have
great.
Some branding issues.
I love the guy that comes up and he's like, can I get chicken? No, we don't have chicken. He's like, put chicken on your logo. It's a stork. Can I get stork?
Right. Like, why is it a stork?
It's such bad branding.
Yeah, it's so
you've weird. Got a bird there, yet you serve no bird.
They only serve
food.
Beef, right?
They only serve burgers.
Yeah. So weird. All right.
No wonder it's not doing so well. And you know, it did the thing that we know about Tasty. She was in charge. She was bright. She was happy. It's like she looked like she was the one that had a future of those two.
Mm-hmm.
And Ward did not.
No.
Ward is the one that brought the pot in there, even though they both did it.
Mm-hmm.
She brought, you know, drugs to work. She was a bit of a screw up. She wasn't really getting her job done. And
when the guy came, when Michael Pence, I think, what was his name? Wait, did I just call him that? Wait, I think that is
it. I thought his name was Spencer, something like
Michael.
That.
Let me see if I can find something that says his name. I swear his name was Mike Pence.
Mike Pence. When Mike Pence showed up.
Michael Spence. I was so close.
You were close.
Okay. And you were close because you added the Spencer part.
Right.
But yeah, Michael Spence, when he comes in, he pulls the gun on him.
Right.
And she had gone to school with him. She knew him. And
right.
And called him out, like
right.
said his name and everything.
And he pulls the gun on her face and she's like, really?
Yeah.
This is what we're going to do? And then she outsmarts him.
Yes, because she's tasty and
Ward's,
she's brilliant.
And Ward's hiding underneath the counter,
peeing
terrified.
Herself.
Yeah, she pees herself.
Mm-hmm.
And Tasty thinks fast.
Mm-hmm.
You know, she gives she tells him that he doesn't want to do this. He doesn't want to rob because as soon as he does, it's going to turn the cameras on and everyone's going to see him. And he starts looking around. And he pulls his hood over, and mm-hmm. she's like, you know, it's already too late.
She said that if she has to open the till at that hour of the night, that
right.
it's going to trigger.
It triggers all the stuff,
yeah.
and the cops will come, and
right.
we'll have video, and he's like, well, fine, then just give me your Jordans.
Yeah.
Now, I didn't think those were Jordans. They were not like the colors were weird, but who knows? I don't know the history of shoes or anything, but they didn't seem like a shoe I'd ever seen. Which was awesome that it turned out they weren't really Jordans.
They were Gordons.
So she outsmarted him. Not only there are no cameras.
Right.
Not only he could have just walked out with anything.
Right.
But she stopped all of it.
Mm-hmm.
And it's interesting because her comment about why was, who are they going to believe? You know,
mm-hmm.
We can't say that this kid came in and stole. They're going to think we did it. That's why she said she did it. But in reality, she did outsmart him. And I think that she also knew, like, she was not a criminal at
mm-hmm.
this point.
Exactly.
And I think that she knew, like, no, you don't steal from this.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to stop him. And she did.
Mm-hmm.
I thought that was awesome.
Yeah.
I love that whole thing.
But
the reason I wanted to do it second, Marth,
mm-hmm.
is at the end of that, basically, Ward says, like, my gosh, you know, you're amazing. Like, she's heaping praise on her. And Tasty's like, oh, it's nothing. And the last shot of them is Ward wants to go, like, party some more. And Tasty's like, nope, I got to go to bed. And they cross two different ways.
Mm-hmm.
So you see where their paths have split right
mm-hmm.
there. And then it goes back and shows how Tasty screwed this up. And you're like, wow, Tasty was really the one who had it together.
Yeah.
Tasty was always the smart one.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe if she had gone right instead of left, her life would have been completely different.
Yeah.
It's really interesting.
Agree.
There you go.
I agree.
That's why I wanted to do that.
All right. Should we talk about Red?
Yep.
So Red.
There isn't a prison person in this part of the conversation, is there?
So, no. So Red is out in the hallway outside of Florida.
Yes.
And sees Frida in there.
Yes.
And they had yogurt and oranges.
Oranges and pudding.
And pudding. And she was like, oh, no, uh-uh.
Yeah.
Hell no, is Frida going to sit in there
right.
and get all that while I'm out here?
Yeah, yeah.
And, and then, my gosh, and she's talking to those girls.
And that one
and the one is like, you can't make lemmings. She's like, it's lemons. And she goes, no, not where I come from. She's like,
if life hands you lemmings.
Run
because they have teeth.
Or something like that, yeah.
She's like, it's lemons, you idiot. And then
so
she
funny.
Had another one.
And
well,
they
really
were
funny.
Saying the one was saying that that someone has a vendetta against Frida, but she called it like a bandana or something.
Yeah,
which
a
was
bandana.
Really funny.
And
and she's like, "Well, I don't know, whatever thing means that they want to kill her."
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
So that actually motivated Red. Red then, you know, is like a dog with a bone because they said, yeah, she had started a prison riot or something and escaped or got out of the situation. And that's why she now gets to be in Florida. And Red's like, why is she in there? So then we see Red in the prison yard and she can't leave well enough alone. Mm-hmm. She's asking.
Because she's Red.
Yes. And she goes up to one of Carol's girls. I don't know if she knew she was Carol's girl at that point. And she says, you know, I'm trying to find out what happened. And obviously some idiot. And the woman's like, oh, really? And she walks right over to Carol. And Red realizes,
oops.
Oh, yeah, Red's face there was awesome. Oh, my God.
Mm-hmm.
I just stirred up a hornet's nest.
Yes, she did.
And it's coming my way.
So they took her to the salon.
Yes.
And they were either going to torture her or help her, depending on her answers to the questions.
Right.
And, of course, she's Red, so she's one of the smartest women in that prison. So she talked her way out of it and let them know. Like, I just figured I had to find someone
but
who hated her.
Frida.
Oh,
up.
Yeah. But she's like, I needed someone who would hate her as much as I do.
Oh, boy.
And so Carol then said, let's fix your hair. So she's now on... In with them.
Yeah.
And they're going to try to deal with Frida.
I really want to know where this is going. Is Frida going to get killed?
Probably.
Did Red just sign her death warrant? You know?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
I think so.
I hope not. I like Frida. I don't want to see her get killed by Carol.
I don't feel strongly.
No? Okay.
I'm willing to see how it plays out.
Okay.
All right. Who else do we have?
Well, we can go back to Piper.
Oh, gosh, Loosecheck.
I was going to say Loosecheck and Piper.
Well, Loosecheck and Mendoza.
Yeah,
with
that's
their
right.
Dance class. You know, with
he's got his dance class, which is how he's smuggling
class,
the foams.
Yeah.
That his dancing was
hilarious. He's really been working it all out, like making sure. You know, he's making this class enjoyable for them, but they keep leaving. And then he's like, no, you can't leave. I have to have at least this many students for it to keep
going. Well, because then he has to go work.
Well, and he can't smuggle the phones.
Right.
So he needs it as a front.
Right.
And he's not getting them engaged. So Mendoza's like, you know, you got to bring some salsa and do some other things. So they're trying. So I like their chemistry, Mendoza and Loosecheck. And I like that they're sort of pairing up to make this better.
Yes.
It's kind of cracking me up. And
yes.
Then Piper went to him knowing about the phones, that he was involved in the phone smuggling. And so she blackmailed him and said, I want kickball.
Which was also awesome.
Oh, it was fantastic. She's like, I want kickball.
Kickball.
He goes,
she's
well, all the blocks have to be in separate. They're not allowed to be in the yard at the same time.
He's like, so how's that going to go?
She's like, you figure it out. Make it work. Make it happen,
oh my
man.
Gosh.
So, yeah, it's all amusing me. But I loved Piper in this episode.
I did, too.
I'm just owning it. As someone who has complained a lot, I am owning the fact that they wrote her well.
Yes. Yeah, it was unexpected because we've been pretty tired of Piper for a while.
Mm-hmm.
And this was a really good Piper episode, even though it was a tasty-centric episode.
Yeah. Well, and then we had, it was a lot of Blanca.
Yeah. I forgot about the Blanca.
How in the heck could you forget about that?
So Nikki's helping her get pregnant. Oh my gosh, Nikki and the
straw. Like, I can't look at a straw ever again.
Oh my gosh. No, I can't.
I can't unsee that.
I can't unsee Diablo in the bathroom.
Oh, gross.
But the best part with that.
And Dia is, with the baggie in
but her. But he's like, at first he's like, I can't do it there. She's like, just go in there and take care of business and we'll come pick it up. He's like, I can't do this. It's public. She's like, you get in there. Mm-hmm. So he goes in and he's like trying to find something to occupy his mind and get him. He sees that horrible little drawing.
Yeah.
I mean, who looks at that and thinks like.
Well, that guy, Diablo.
Diablo. Like, oh my gosh, dude.
Yeah.
That was his thing. So, he ends up leaving. We'll say a deposit.
A baggie
in the bathroom. And
Dia finds it and it's still warm, which gags me. And then she puts it in her bra.
Right.
And gets it to Nikki and Blanca. And Nikki gets her laying down in the library.
Oh, my gosh. This scene was unbelievable.
And she's using the straw to blow it in.
Yeah.
And then the Carol's people, right?
Carol's people
showed up.
And they're like, oh, boy. And Nikki's down there like, I spent a lot of time down here. You know, I could do things. I could.
Oh, my gosh.
And Block is just looking like, oh, my God.
Make it stop.
And wasn't it the same ones that were already like, on her about the trading the drugs with Dia, it was the same girls.
Mm-hmm.
So they're like, they are watching Blanca. and this is what they come up on. Like, what the heck?
Pretty shocking.
Yes. To say the least.
Yes. And funny.
Yeah. But it was hilarious. But I thought we were going to have a real problem right there, but they didn't come back to it. So who knows? So what do you think? Is that it?
No.
Oh, it's not.
Probably more. Let me think. Did we talk about, did Dia do much? She was the one who went and got her the.
Right. She got the baggie. Thing. She, was trying to get the drugs for Daddy and, the girls stopped her. So she stole a couple of them. And then Daddy was like, those are.
She was keeping some for herself.
Right. Daddy's like, those were for you. And she's like, well.
Yeah.
But then Daddy defused it because they got busy.
Mm-hmm.
So that's about it for Dia.
Okay.
I can't think of anyone that we didn't really.
Well, and the reason that Dia was helping Blanca wasn't that so that Blanca would give her.
Yeah, it was that. That was what we were talking about. Blanca was getting
I'm trying to remember
giving her the drugs from D Block.
Yeah. Oh, that was it. And then she was supposed to go retrieve the deposit.
Baggie. Yes.
The baggie from under
the deposit.
Diablo's deposit.
Yeah.
Okay.
That was still warm. So that's what was going on there. That's why they were working together and all that sequence of events happened.
Carol's people jumped Dia and stole the
pills.
Barbara's pills.
Right.
Yeah.
But not the deposit.
Right.
So there you go.
Oh, Alita.
Oh yeah. This was a little thing, but this was cool.
And it went throughout the episode.
Yeah. So she figured out. That she was having trouble. She was having trouble selling this stuff, and she can't figure out where she can go with it. And somebody said to her, "The thing about go to where they need it." So she goes to the prison parking lot,
mm-hmm.
which was really smart. But there's no way that was going to last,
right?
And what's his name came out.
Hopper.
Hopper comes out and stops her. He's like, "You can't do that here." But you could go out to dinner with me. And it wasn't creepy. It wasn't like.
No, he took her to Red Lobster. He
took her to Red Lobster. Endless biscuits.
Mm-hmm. Did he know her in there?
Not if she wasn't in Max.
I mean, we never saw him before, though,
no.
right? So she never, they didn't
no,
know
No, she
each
said
other.
To him, I was an inmate, didn't
yeah,
she?
I thought so.
I believe she did. I know she said it to that guy that bought from her. So she did sell some
stuff.
Yeah, because,
well, she figured out how to use her story.
Right. Right, which is great.
Yeah.
But he, to my knowledge, he never had an encounter with her.
I didn't think so.
So
she was gone by then.
Right.
So, yeah. So he took her to Red Lobster. He helped her load her car back up and then took her to Red Lobster.
Yes. With endless biscuits or whatever.
Endless biscuits.
Cheesy biscuits. You can tell we don't go to Red Lobster.
Well,
sorry,
we're
that's
allergic,
not going to be a sponsor. But
we're allergic to gluten and dairy, so it's not like we're eating cheesy biscuits anytime.
Right. And what fun is lobster without the butter at a Red Lobster? So
probably not.
Probably not, indeed.
Anyway.
Okay.
I think we did, too.
We
probably got it all.
I think we got it.
Okay.
I think it's good. I think I'm ready for the next episode. I know I'm ready for the next episode. I want to see what happens at the kickball game.
I hope they keep writing Piper like this because that was enjoyable.
Yes. Well, they're giving her something to do, which is always good. You know, when she was the gangster, she had something to do. It was entertaining. When she doesn't have anything to do, she's just the worst.
That's
so
true.
They're giving her something to do. You can follow us on Twitter at Orange Podcast. You can find us on Facebook. We have conversation going there, as we pointed out earlier in the episode. In the show notes, we added the Orange is the New Black podcast t-shirt. So you can get a t-shirt for the show, and that helps support us, which is awesome. You can also send us an email at southgatemediagroup@gmail.com. And I will point out, at the front of the episode, we've added an ad for Tweaked headphones. I have a pair. They're awesome. Here's something we don't say on the ad. We say that you get 30% off. You also get free shipping and a lifetime warranty, which I have used because I broke two pair, sent it right back. They sent me new headphones. New, not refurbished, new headphones to replace them. It was fantastic. So if you're in the market for some headphones, or you know somebody that might want some for one of the holidays coming up, because they are coming up, you definitely want to order some Tweaked headphones. I think that's it. Martha, have you got anything else to say? Well, I have one more thing to say then. Inmates, back to yourselves.